Okay, guys, we're probably about 100 kilometers from Cannes and 190 from Cherbourg. And I'm feeling all kinds of chatty this morning, so just a little bit more enthusiast talk. I've already complained this car is not mine, but if it were, what would I change? And I'll tell you, there are three things I would definitely change. And one thing I'd probably change. Let me go over them one at a time. First of all, the DCT. We've all talked about this already. Yes, it's a fantastic transmission. Efficient, fast, quick. Performs better than any human possibly ever could. But if I were to get this car, for me, it would be about involvement. It wouldn't be about all-out razor's edge performance. It'd be about me enjoying it and me being a part of it and me taking part in the driving experience. And for me, that means a 6-speed manual. So change number one, a third pedal. Secondly, I delete the roof window. Yeah, it's actually pretty good, especially for filming, because it gives me a nice little hair light, shows off my features, my high cheekbones. But nah, not for me. I think I would rather just have a solid roof, a more rigid chassis, and all that goes along with that. I don't actually know that the chassis is more rigid. I mean, I would think it's gotta be more rigid without a moonroof. And I would think it's definitely gotta be lighter. I just don't have the specs on it. I mean, I would imagine adding that up there has gotta be at least 40 pounds, maybe as much as 60, 70, 80 pounds. And it's in the wrong place. It's right on top of the car. Last thing I would do is I would delete the 19-inch wheels. Yes, they're pretty, yes, they're beautiful, but folks, they are heavy with a capital H. And for enthusiasts, you know that every pound you put at the corners is bad. I mean, I would not be surprised if these 19s with the tires were 50 pounds a corner. Not that the 18s are gonna be flyweights, but I mean, they're gonna be less. And I would be tempted to put an aftermarket set of 18s that were actually lightweight and had some high performance rubber on them. Because I think this car would really, really come alive. And on top of that, I do not even want to know what these 19s cost to replace. I gotta believe that you're $1,500 if you're a dollar, and you might come close to $2,000 depending on what kind of rubber you get. I'm sorry, I love these cars. I know they're expensive to keep running, but whoo, that's more than I signed up for. And finally, the fourth thing that I would probably change, maybe not, the exterior color. And that's the one thing that I kind of was bummed about when I saw the M3's colors. I don't think this car comes in anything really that fun. I think most of the colors are pretty serious and a bit on the dowdy side, quite frankly. I think if there's one fun color, it'd be the Interlagos blue. But it's a bright blue, and I know that's not for everyone. I wish they would come back with Dakar yellow. If I could have a M3 sedan in Dakar yellow, yeah. I know a lot of you are puking in your mouths right now. Shut up! I like it, okay? But I think the Dakar yellow would actually look pretty good on this car, with a black interior, and maybe keep the carbon leather, or maybe make it wood or even the aluminum. But those would be the three things I'd change, and the fourth thing I'd probably change.